How about doing one more decoupage plate, but this time with some really nice twist? Welcome back, friends. This is Sonia here from Growing Craft, and this is the new plate which I have done. So these are the beautiful design decoupage papers which I had, and I absolutely love these ones. And I thought I wanted to try my hand on one of these and create beautiful decoupage plate. Now to start with, I need to just mark the center circle portion on my paper, and for that I'm just tracing it out so that my works become easier. I don't have to mark it and draw a circle around it. So with this marking, I am just going to cut it around. I just thought that I'll use my pencil, but then I guess this is the most easier part and the most easier way of doing and tracing your work. Now my white portion looks much more clear because on the front side I have the design, so that's why I'm cutting from the back side so that I can easily see the mark of my trace work, and with my scissor I'm cutting this work. Now this is what I had decided. That's the reason I am taking up this paper of a smaller size than the plate. This is just the central portion of the part. On the outer coverings I'm going to do some other work with some twists, so stay tuned till end. Now once I'm done with my cutting work, I just felt that this looks good, the size is quite good, and actually my paper size is 12 by 12, so like the 12 inch dia, so this is going to look really good with some really nice shades. So I have planned to add acrylic colors. So one is the acrylic regular red color, and the other one is the shimmery paint, and I'm going to dab this with my sponge dauber on my plate, the side areas of my plate. Now here, as you can see, my paper has some blue shades, maroon shade, cream color shade, so I just thought of having those shades on my sides. These shades are basically just to complement my decoupage paper. So here, once I'm done with my red color, then I'm going to add my blue color to it. And as you can see, that sponge dauber is just a perfect medium to blend in your colors, and this makes your color blending work really, really, really easy. Now the reason why I have taken two different sponge dauber here, cause I was not really sure that how and where I'm going to have more of blue and red. So I just thought I will have two different brushes, and which will make my work easier. Now I need to rotate my plate to blend in the colors, so moving around with a bottle beneath that is really making my work easier. I've just kept a white regular normal napkin, the tissue paper, above that so that my glass plate does not get any scratches or marks. So this is how I am going to blend in the colors. And one more thing, my red color is really, really, really wet. So the reason why I'm blending it now, so that my color blending looks more natural and more simple. So that's the reason I'm blending it now. And trust me, you can plan out and do this with any colors you want, any shades you want, and the end results are going to look really, really, really amazing. So I'm going to repeat the same process on my complete plate, and I'm going to make sure that whenever I require more of red color or blue color, I'll add that. Now I'm adding few more shades of red here and there wherever it's required, and this is just to fill up the spaces where I have missed out the colors. And this is really looking really, really nice, and I'm super happy with the way it has turned out. I'll be just adding few more tinge of red here and there, and with my sponge dauber I'm going to give it a very good blend. Now I am going to use my Mod Podge. It's a matte finish Mod Podge, and I am going to stick my decoupage paper with this. Now with a paintbrush I am going to apply this on the sides of my plate and the complete area, and I am just going to make sure that I apply a generous amount of Mod Podge so that it sticks really well to my plate. Now after sticking my paper, I'm going to give it a good press with my sponge dauber. Now this is a completely new sponge dauber which is completely dry, and with this I'm going to press my paper really well, and I'm just going to make sure that I do not leave any bubbles or gaps or wrinkles here and there. Now my paper becomes a little wet, so it is leaving out some of the paper particles, but then that's absolutely fine. With a flat brush, I'm just going to clean up the rest of the areas, and this is absolutely looking gorgeous now. But do await till ends for some more twist for my project. Here I had started doing my chalk paint, and then I realized then maybe I was not really happy with the way, and it was not turning out the way I wanted it. Yes, it was covering up the patches, the spaces, but I was looking out for some more results. But then I thought I wanted to give it a try, and then with my paintbrush I started making the designs on my paint. Now with the acrylic paint, as I had not used any gesso, so removing that paint was super easy. So, and it has not got any varnish till now. So here with my backside of the paintbrush, I'm just making the same petal leaf design on the complete areas of the borders of my plate, which you can see on the chalk paint area. And this is just going to be of the random sizes, and the angles are going to be different. And then I'm going to cover that all these marks with a chalk paint, so that is going to give a contrast color on the front side of my glass. So I guess that is the fun part of working with a glass plate, that you can do so many variations and you can just play around with the materials and the supplies which is there with you in your craft room. So once I'm done with that, then I'm covering it completely with my chalk paint, and like I said, I'm using all the shades which is already there in my decoupage paper, so that it gives a very good one family kind of feeling to my plate. So here I'm just covering up all the points where I had done the marking with my paintbrush with my chalk paint. Once it is done, then I'm going to cover it up with my varnish, and I'm going to apply generously 2-3 coats of varnish. And when you're applying varnish, please make sure that you do not rub on the painted areas again and again. This is actually going to take out all your paint, so please be really careful. Just give one coat of color, let it dry completely for 1 or 2 days or 3 days, and then you start the other coloring work. My project is done, and I hope you all enjoyed this tutorial. Thank you so much for watching. I have already posted all the links down in the description box. Do check that. If you have any queries, please do comment down below. Thank you. Bye bye.